about your experiences.
Well,
everybody has to
be and around the world.
What did I
welcome again to another edition of Real Sports Talk with Emmy. And I mean real talk.
What are the things that
and this is a real talk. No. For the past 10 years, I've been hosting my game in there. One of the most successful games in there. And it brought up a lot of stuff. And I continue to push for games. Right? And it has been a challenge. But nevertheless, I accept the challenge. But I've been working with different countries, and the attitude towards athletics and towards the approach towards the country people getting scholarship is totally different. Now, while we may argue that at the CHC, right, that Guyanese are doing better at the CHC level, right? Now, I had a few arguments with a few people in Guyana that I totally disagree with. Now, you can get 21 CHC, and I've mentioned it many times in this program. Many times, you can get 18 CHC. All that means is a school leading service. That's all I can do. But then you get an 18 CHC, but then guess what? You're working in a store. You're a sales clerk in one of them Chinese stores. You're a sales clerk in, you're working at B-Pad. I mean, you're working at a store. Put it that way. Does that make any sense? Compare to the Caribbean now, where, as you guys saying in there, that you are smarter in terms of subjects, but according to the last time I checked, Cuba and Barbados are the highest rated literate country in the Caribbean. The last time I checked that, Barbados and Cuba is the most literate country in the Caribbean. This is the last time that I checked. So y'all can do your research, maybe a change. But the last time I checked, that was my result. Another thing, y'all could have your disagreement. There were more children from Jamaica, Barbados, Trinidad, Antigua that goes to college than Guyanese. Listen to me again. There are more children in Jamaica, Guyana, let me rephrase that. There are more children in Jamaica, Barbados, Trinidad, and Antigua, those kids that go to college than Guyana. Now listen to this. Pass rate. Listen to this. Guyana don't have a million. Trinidad got more than a million. Jamaica got more than a million. So the population is higher. See, if you do per capita or per thousand, Guyana will have a higher rate because of the low population compared to the higher population. Like, for instance, if I do per capita of 1,000 and I have 10,000, see, if I do 1 per 1,000, I have 10,000 people. So you're going to go 1/10. Compared to if you have 5,000, and you do per capita, it's gonna be 1/5. So obviously, right, 1/5 is greater than 1/10. Obviously, because I may have 2 million people, right? So go per capita. So maybe y'all didn't understand what's going on. But anyway, don't let me get in argument. Let me get in argument. But anyway, I gotta tell y'all, I am fed up. Right now, I've been talking to some of my colleagues, some people that is assisting. I am fed up. talking to my black brothers and sisters, insisting to them why the children need to get a higher education. Again, I am fed up and I am tired talking to my black brothers and sisters, telling them why it is important for their children to get a higher education. Why is it important that their children go to college and university, especially the people that are in poverty? Education can take you out of poverty. But guess what? I deal with track and field. So I'm trying to encourage the parents of athletes that is in track and field. Why is it important to send their children to university and college? But for some reason, coaches in Guyana don't want the children to go on scholarship, and they don't want the children them to go to get a higher education. Coaches, no, they're not no coach. I will tell you, no coach can tell me that my children cannot get a higher education. You got A1 now. It is mandatory. My children don't have an option. They have to get a higher education. My children, they have to get a higher education. Because guess what? Today, tomorrow, sports done, they have a career. They have a bachelor, a master's, a degree. They have something to draw back on. So that's why it's important to get a higher education. But parents in Guyana, my black brothers and sisters, you have to prefer that your children conduct on a bus, sell in a store, and open a shop on the corner. You are comfortable with that. Now, I don't have a problem because I am not comfortable with that. So guess what? Tell you all discipline. Look at my face straight. I am not going to tell no other parent in Guyana. I am not seeking no other child in Guyana that are athletes. And talking to the parents and family member why they need to get a higher education. Stop it. I'm not doing it. So guess what? Hudson, you don't have to worry yourself. Right? Christmas coming, you get your Christmas wish. The children them going to stay in Guyana because they are better off in Guyana. So all of our sponsors that are watching this video, Andy Metascape, have made the decision to move my program to other countries in the Caribbean and leave out Guyana. Again, to all of my sponsors that are looking, I, Andy Mereskin, have decided to pull my program from Guyana. I won't be hosting no more games, right? And I won't be seeking athletes from, track and field athletes from Guyana to go on scholarship and to get a higher education. I'm done. So Hudson and coaches, you guys don't have to worry no more. Parents, y'all ain't got to worry about me calling you guys, spending hours on the phone, trying to tell you guys why it's important that your children must get a higher education. Look around y'all in Guyana. Who own the businesses? Right? Who own the houses? Who own the land? Look around you guys. Y'all ain't waking up. But here what for now? I am the middle school. I've taken the decision to focus on my two girls and to focus on other people in the Caribbean that need it. So, again, Hudson and the track and field coaches, y'all don't have to worry about me trying to reach out to you guys to encourage you guys why it's important that your children must get a higher education. Y'all don't have to worry. Because I'm not going to do it no more. I'm going to save my energy for my kids and focus on other countries in the Caribbean. So this is short because I'm tired of explaining to parents why the children need to pass their CXC. I'm tired of telling parents why their children need to go to sixth form. So if you guys satisfied with your children writing CXC and thinking it's a big thing, CXC is no big thing. A bachelor's at least, not an associate degree. But guess what? You guys thinking that 15 CFC subjects mean anything? They don't mean anything. It's a school leaving certificate. All that say that you finish high school. You gotta go on to university now. Who's gonna pay the cost? How are you gonna attain a bachelor's to apply in the competitive world? Amazon needs people, right? We have Google need people. We have Tesla need people. So much companies is coming up IPO right now on the stock market that need talented people with bachelor's, master's, and all of these things. We have the electric cars coming out. Watch, we have the oil company in Guyana. Can't even hire you guys because y'all don't have no education. Now they gotta bring people now from overseas to work in Guyana. How sensible of you guys to don't want your children to get a higher education. So then, who is going to take over the oil sector in Guyana when you guys don't want your children them to go and get a higher education? Y'all going to be slave in Guyana to your own economy. Because guess what? It is education that took me out of poverty. I used to live on the streets. And if I didn't have an education, I could have never been where I am today. It's education is what took me out of poverty. And you ask anybody what takes them out of poverty? Education. So if you guys, you parents, do not want your children to go and get a higher education, the oil sector in Guyana, y'all gonna be in Guyana and foreigners is gonna take over the oil sector and y'all gonna be a slave in your own country. You guys not doing anything. Right? And to the AAG, y'all not doing me anything. Y'all not doing me anything. The athletes can stay in there because I don't have to call no athlete, no coach come and tell me that I trying to get their athlete in the ground. So to all the sponsors, thank you for all you guys have done. You guys did a wonderful job. You know what I mean? I can't thank you guys because without you guys, I could have never made this program, could have never gone this far. But enough is enough. I fed up fighting. I fed up. They don't want to register my club. I fed up. I fed up with the back and forth. I fed up. I just fed up. Right? I can be focusing my energy on doing something else. So I'm going to focus my resources. Because remember, a lot of the money that I pump into this game is my personal money. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to channel my resources somewhere else. I'm not rich. I don't come to Guyana with money. I buy assets. So I don't have money on me. You ask anybody in there. You go to the shop, I credit. Right? The store that supply me with anything that I have, you ask them. I credit it from them and then I pay them later. Because I don't have money. I'm not afraid to say that. In the US, I use credit card. I buy and then I pay later. That's how the system works, credit. So I use credit. I don't have cash. So the little cash that I would save up to spend on your children, right? You know what I mean? My credit card payment will be less. It's going to be less. So I'm going to be able to manage myself better. So I don't have to bother you athletes anymore. I don't have to bother you coaches anymore. Parents, I don't have to be calling you anymore. You don't want your children to study for bars at CFC. So I don't have to send no program for your children to study for bars at CFC. I don't have to do that. Parents, I don't have to do that anymore. I don't have to send your children to extra lesson to get extra teaching. I don't have to buy computers, bring it down to Diana to give it to your kids, them that the kids them could study. Maybe your wife, kids them take the computer for their games. That's fine with me. I don't have a problem. I don't have to buy no more computers anymore. I don't have to do that. Right, I'd have to send them a training program. I'll take my knowledge and my aspiration to another country because you guys don't want me to encourage y'all for your children to get a higher education. So we don't have to do this. So AAG, you get your wish. You don't have to do it. I'm gonna register my club. That's okay. Right? I'm out. Simple. Right? I'm going to focus on who is already out of Diana. I'm going to focus on them. They're out. I'm going to put the resources to the five athletes that are out of Diana right now. And I'm going to focus on other countries. That's it. I don't have to argue with nobody. I don't have to tell you. I don't have to call you and tell you your daughter needs to go and study, your son needs to go and study, your son needs to pick up a book. You guys want to work as I'm not knocking nobody. You want to do security guard job? I don't have a problem. If you're comfortable with your son and daughter just finish high school and do a security guard job, hey, I'm not knocking nobody. A job is a job. If you're comfortable with your daughter working in a store, hey, I'm not knocking nobody. A job is a job. If you're comfortable with your son becoming a conductor, a minibus conductor, hey, I'm not knocking nobody. A job is a job. If you're comfortable with your son driving a taxi for somebody, hey, I'm not knocking nobody. You guys can choose the road you want your children them to go down. It's your children. For my children, they have to get an higher education. Because guess what? I dropped to the University of Ghana because I couldn't afford it. But guess what? I'm going to make sure I afford that my children have finished the university. And for some of the colleges, I don't afford it. I can't afford to pay it. So they got to get a scholarship to go. That's the reason for scholarship. Scholarship. Oh, coach. You coach in Guyana that say you don't believe in scholarship, I wish you well. You don't believe in scholarship, I wish you well. But I believe in scholarship because guess what? $500,000, I cannot pay for my child to study to be a doctor or a lawyer or go to Yale or Harvard. I cannot afford $500,000. So my kids them will need a scholarship to go to Duke, Syracuse, the Ivy League schools. Put it that way. I cannot afford to pay to send my children to the Ivy League schools. I can't afford to send them there. So I didn't need a scholarship. Because scholarship paid a cost. That's what scholarship is. They paid a cost. So guess what? I don't have to call no more parents. I don't have to call no more auntie, no more uncle, no more cousin. And encourage y'all to write your CXC. We're subject to study. We'll do CAPE. We'll go to sixth form. We'll go to the university. I don't have to do that anymore. Right? I'm out. I take it to another country. Simple as that. Alright, so Hudson, I hope you're happy now. Right? You can laugh. But remember, who had the last laugh? Last laugh the best. Just remember that. Hudson, you can laugh now. Coaches, you can laugh now. But remember, who got the last laugh? Laugh the best. Because my children have no choice but to get a higher education. What about you? Yeah, you. What about your children? Your children. Right? My brother, my black brothers and sisters, you comfortable with your child working in the store, conducting a bus, right? Working taxi, and being a security guard. Seriously? Really? Comfortable with that? Wish y'all well.